eventually there is this moment where the heart absorbs the mind. The Sufis have this expression of the mind is hammered into the heart. But there is this moment when the heart just and the mind is gone. At the beginning, you don't even know it's happened because you have no mind. But it is, strictly speaking, the first experience in this incarnation you have ever had of the mind not functioning. Because even when you are asleep, the mind, as you know, dreams and is busy. But in that moment of dhyana, the mind has gone. Where it has gone is a $10,000 question. They say that the individual mind is absorbed into the universal mind. All you know is that you don't know. And you don't even know initially that you don't know. Just gone. Later, it becomes completely intoxicating. Just not to be here for a moment, not to be here, then, of course, it gets deeper and deeper. And you can go off for an hour, you can go off for 2 hours, and you're just gone. And it's the first time in this life you have been completely free from this outer world of forms and images. And you become absorbed somewhere else. And Sufism is about absorption. You are absorbed by love. Love draws you into itself. Remember in the first talk I gave, for those of you who are here, I talked about this place where the two seas meet, this whole esoteric meaning of being in the place where the two seas meet. And I said there is the sea of our human experience, all of our troubles and feelings and happiness, all of what we call it means to be a human being. And then there is the sea of divine consciousness, or the sea of the divine. And the first step really is to learn how to be at this place where the two seas meet, so you can experience the divine ocean, so you can experience this other sea that really takes you into the ocean of oneness, takes you back into love, takes you into these states of absorption with God, however you describe them. And in the story in the Quran, it is Moses who had to find the place where the two seas meet, to meet with Khidr, who is the figure of mystical experience. And I think that meditation is a way to be in that place where the two seas meet. Because one thing you realize once you go deep into meditation is how you are taken by God to God. You don't do anything. This is not a path of effort. This is not a path of, because how can you? How can there be an effort with divine things? You don't know how to get back to God. You don't know how to become lost in love. You don't know how to get absorbed in the ocean of divine oneness. But you can be at that place where the divine sea comes crashing into conscious existence and then takes you back, like the tide, takes you deeper and deeper into this other ocean, into this ocean of the divine, into this extraordinary reality that exists beyond the mind and all its thoughts, into this, you can call it the ocean of love, you can. And that is, for me, really when mystical life becomes real. All of your practices, all of your effort, you have been sitting there maybe for 5, 6 years and nothing has happened. And then there is a sweetness within the heart when you come out of meditation. Then there is, or a moment of bliss, or what is it that has touched you? What is it that has taken you? And then you begin to get caught by this current of love. And there are currents of love, because it is that takes you back to God. Not your effort, not your, I should do this or that, because that's about you. But to be in a place where you can first be receptive to the voice of God, but then to go deeper and to give yourself to the tide of this ocean that comes from the beyond, and takes souls back to God.